Do you think you can do this tile installation? Guess what? You can! The following steps will review the fundamentals of wall tile installation. Firstly, always unpack every piece of your tile and make sure that you have enough to complete your project. The best way to confirm that you have enough tile to complete your project is to lay out your tile prior to installation, exactly how it will be installed. Mix tiles from all of the different cases, ensuring that your tiles share an array of handmade variation. In this example, a shower wall tile design is being laid out on top of a tabletop before installation. Once all of the tiles are spread out, include appropriately sized spacers between the tiles. This will ensure that your layout is representative of the installed project. As part of your layout, you will most likely need to cut some tile. Mark lines on all tiles that need to be cut as they correspond with your tile installation parameters. We recommend cutting all needed tiles prior to installation. Once you have all tiles, including cut pieces and spacers laid out, begin drawing an installation grid on your installation surface. Your specific grid can vary in line density based on the tile that you're using and the area of your installation. Your grid lines should measure the size of 4 pieces of tile in a square. For example, if you're using 8-inch tile with a 1/4-inch grout joint, then your grid square should measure 16.5 by 16.5 inches. It's time to install tile. Using a high-grade glue that is compatible with your installation surface, begin troweling the adhesive between the grid lines. Only trowel 1 to 2 grid sections at a time. Begin taking tiles from your layout, 1 grid section at a time, and install them onto your installation surface. If your tiles are directional, make sure that you're installing them in the correct direction. Make sure that the edges of the tile you're installing are lined up and flush with the corresponding pieces. Continue installing your tiles 2 grids at a time until all tiles are installed. After the adhesive is dried, begin pulling the tile spacers from the joints. It's time to apply grout. Using an appropriate grout, begin troweling the grout across the tile surface in a diagonal direction, pressing firmly and filling the joints fully. Compress as much of the grout between the joints as possible, allowing only a minimal amount to remain on the tile surface. Only apply grout to sections of approximately 3 to 4 square feet at a time. That's about 8 tiles. Immediately following grout application to each section, begin cleaning away grout residue from the tile surface with water and a sponge, wiping in a circular motion. Continue applying grout sections and cleaning residue from the surface until the entire installation area is completely grouted. After the entire area has been cleaned, a thin layer of grout residue may remain. It's okay. This residue can be cleaned during the final cleaning. For the final cleaning, 24 hours after grout application, use a combination of mild detergent, such as dishwashing soap and warm water. The final cleaning should remove all remaining residue from the tile surface. Though there is no substitute for experience, following these instructions and taking your time will result in a pretty good tile installation.